Hello everyone, I am Mr. Ashok Kumar from vtuprojects.com and AKLC. In this video, I am going to explain to you about the project Sentiment Analysis of Twitter Corpus related to Artificial Intelligence Assistance. So these are the things that I am going to explain to you in this video. So first I am going to list out some of the quick facts and summary about your project, and then I am going to tell you the problem identification, and then I am going to walk you through some of the existing system which is known as literature review for this project, and then I'm going to mention the system that we are going to propose along with its advantages, and at last I'm going to mention the list of all hardwares and softwares required to implement our project. So these are the quick facts that you should be knowing about your project. The first one is, what is the domain of your project? The domain of our project comes as machine learning and artificial intelligence. So this is the area where we will be working on, and the reference. So base reference indicates from where we actually got the idea from. So we got the idea from an IEEE 2018 paper. So it is the recent IEEE publication. So from there we got the idea and we are implementing it by our own. And which algorithm we are going to use? So we are going to use an algorithm called Vader. So the expansion for Vader will be valency aware dictionary and sentiment reasoning. So this is the expansion for the term Vader. So we are going to make use of this algorithm for detecting the sentiment from the given text. Okay, and then the which framework and the platform we will be using to implement our project. So we will be basically using the Java framework on Windows or Linux platform. Okay, so whichever you are comfortable in, so we can use that platform, but the core framework will be Java and J2EE. So, and the number of lines of code that will be required to implement this project can be approximately 4000 lines of code. So, on an average, any final year project work will be completed within 1000 or sometimes 1500 lines of code. But we will be writing around 4000 lines of code in this particular project. So not that the project will be complicated. So because of the number of modules and the features we are going to add in this project, so we will be requiring these many lines of code, and each and every lines of code will be easier for you guys to understand. And the percentage of the database used will be maximum 6% of the database. The reason why I'm putting this point here is because most of the universities says you should not use more than 20% of the database. So we are well within the safer side because we are using at most 6% of the database. So let us come to the problem identification in our project. So before stating the problem, let us understand what you mean by sentiment analysis. So most of you people know that sentiment analysis refers to the practice of applying natural language processing. We in short call it as NLP. And also the text analysis techniques for identifying and extracting person's opinion and feelings from a piece of text. So for example, many people will be commenting on a product that they have purchased from Amazon or Flipkart or something like that, and some people will be posting some textual data on Facebook or Twitter, so like that. So those piece of text will actually indicate the opinion of that person. Say it says whether the person is happy or sad, angry, something like that. So our goal is to extract that mood, extract that opinion of that particular person from a given piece of text. For example, so let us have a look at one of the tweet about the Facebook Messenger app. One of the persons said, so literally your Facebook message app is useless. You only want it to increase profit. Please fix yourself. It's sad. So this is one of the real review on the Facebook messaging app in Google Play Store. Okay, so the one who reads this comment will be easily understanding that the person is not happy with the service given by Facebook Messenger app. So it's like if a human is reading this, you know, message, he will be getting to know the opinion of that particular person. But you guys know that there will be billions of comments, millions of textual data posted in Facebook, Twitter or something like that. So we need to automate that process. We need to write some algorithms to read the text and find out the opinion of that person. Okay, so we need to write an algorithm which says this particular text indicates the person is sad, something like that. So that's what we call sentiment analysis. So one more example would be, so this is the product review about Canon camera. So one person said, so I really enjoyed using the camera in Madrid. So the Canon is much better than the Panasonic, something like that. So if a human is reading this comment, he will be getting to know that the person who written this review is happy about the product, right? But we cannot expect a human to read this and, you know, categorize the comments into positive, neutral or negative, something like that, right? So we need to write an algorithm which will automate the process of finding the opinion of a person from the textual data. So that is what the problem that of our project. So I can formally state the problem of your project as like this. So there's a wealth of information out there hidden in individuals' comments, emails, tweets, form submission, reviews. And the main challenge is wrangling all this info and extracting the value from it. So we need to come up with an efficient algorithm, so which will extract the useful information from that textual data. So this is what the problem statement for your project. So now let us understand what are all the existing systems available to solve the problem that we stated earlier. So you people know that sentiment analysis is not a new thing that we are going to propose actually. So there are some existing solutions already available for finding out the opinion from the text of a given person. Okay, so some of the papers were published on sentiment analysis. So few of them are listed here. So Lee and Pang have proposed this particular solution in 2002. So and the same authors have published another solution. So and one more author called Vinodini and Chandrasekharan have proposed this particular paper. So all these particular paper basically deals with the approaches for finding out the sentiment from a given piece of text. Okay, so these paper basically will be making use of various algorithms. So few algorithms they are going to use is Naive Bayes algorithm. So they are going to use K nearest neighbor, so we call it as KNN algorithm. And they have also used a support vector machine, SVM algorithm. So they are basically using various algorithms for finding out the sentiment analysis from a given piece of text. So but basically all the existing sentiment analysis technique have a major drawbacks. Okay, so I can say all those existing sentiment analysis techniques have two major drawbacks which we are actually solving in our project. Okay, so the first major drawback in all of the existing sentiment analysis technique is, so they are all our standalone solution. So the meaning of standalone solution is, so you will have to either visit their site or download their solution into your machine and then use the solution. So you cannot use it over the cloud as a service. So if you want to analyze your text, so you have to download their solution entirely into your machine and then you will have to execute their solution to find out the opinion from the given piece of text. So we call this as standalone. So but in our project we are going to implement the solution over the cloud in a as a service module. So as a service model will enable the customers to use our solution anywhere across the world simply using making use of internet calls. Okay, so you will understand all these things in detail during the project classes, but right now you just have to focus on the high level explanation about the drawbacks. Okay, so the first drawback is all of the existing solutions are implemented in a standalone way. Okay, I can say no as a service model. Okay, so no as a service model has been implemented, but we are going to implement our solution in a as a service model. So that means we can call it as sentiment analysis as a service model. Okay, and the second most important drawback of the existing system is, so they are not going to, you know, preserve the privacy of the text. Say for example, if you people belong to some particular company and you have taken the feedback of your company from your employees, so you need to analyze the feedback of your company given by your employees. So if you are making use of any of the existing solution, it's like you are exposing your data to them, so they can actually read your feedback and they can steal that information. Okay, so even though a program is actually reading that information, they can hack that program and steal all the feedback of your company given by your employees. So it's like the privacy is not preserved. Okay, so but we are going to solve this problem also. So by making sure we are going to analyze the text, so after encryption, so or after hashing it into some unreadable format. So that means even a program will not be able to read the plain text of the given data, something like that. Okay, so these are the two major drawback of the existing system. So now coming to the proposed system. So in this project, we are actually collecting some of the text like tweets from Twitter, and we are going to classify them into positive, negative and neutral. So that means we are actually extracting the opinion of the person given a tweet. So and for that purpose, we are making use of VADER algorithm, valence aware dictionary and sentiment reasoner algorithm. So you don't have to worry about how this algorithm will be implemented. So in detail, the explanation will be given in the project class. So you just have to understand what are we going to implement in our project as of now. And apart from analyzing the textual tweets from Twitter, so we are also going to implement our solution as sentiment as a service model, so that any user across the world can simply make use of our solution over the internet call. So basically our solution will be available worldwide. So for that purpose, we are going to deploy our solution on a live cloud. So like Amazon Web Service, something like that. So the now coming to the advantage of our project. So there were a couple of drawbacks of our existing systems, right? Well, first is there was no as a service model. So that advantage and disadvantage has been overcome now. So by implementing our solution as a service, sentiment as a service model. So we are going to implement our solution in a sentiment analysis as a service model. So the advantage of this particular, you know, model is that anyone across the world can access our solution without actually downloading our project into their machine. So simply making a internet call, so they will be able to access our solution. And the second advantage of our project is we are going to preserve the privacy of the text. So we will not analyze the text as it is. We are first going to encrypt the text, or we are going to convert the text into some hash, and then we are going to analyze it, so that even we will not be able to read the plain text. So we are going to preserve the privacy of our customers. So these are the couple of advantages of our project. So coming to the hardware requirement, so we will be requiring some standard machine configuration for implementing our project, like a processor with minimum 2.4 gigahertz speed and at least 2 GB of RAM and minimum 40 GB of hard disk, and obviously keyboard and mouse, and so a monitor with minimum 32 bit color settings and USB interface and power adapter, etc. So main thing is coming to the software requirements. So we will be requiring either Windows or Linux operating system. So whichever you are comfortable with, so we can go with that operating system. And for the programming language in the backend, we will make use of Core Java, Advanced Java, JEE, and Model View Controller Framework. And in the front end, we will make use of HTML, CSS, JavaScript, Ajax, jQuery, and Twitter Bootstrap Framework.
and we will code our entire project using Eclipse or NetBeans, so whichever you are comfortable with. And we'll be making use of Apache Tomcat server or WebLogic server, once again whichever you are comfortable with. So, and from for the database, we will either use MySQL or Oracle. So you can choose whatever tools you want. So the training for each of them will be given from the scratch. So I hope you people understood this project. So if you have any questions on this project, or if your colleges asked you any questions, so please make a note of all those questions and bring it to my attention, so that I can answer to those questions and you can go back to them and answer it. So if you have any questions related to this project, so please send all those questions to aklc.contact@gmail.com. So if you want the answers right away, feel free to call me on 97420-24066. Thank you so much.